We all know someone, right?
Yeah.
That person who, well, despite maybe not knowing a whole lot, speaks with just absolute certainty.
Oh, yeah. It really makes you wonder, doesn't it? Why is it that sometimes the people who seem to know the least are so utterly convinced they know the most?
Exactly. And that's really the core of what we're digging into in this deep dive today.
We've got some pretty compelling material here that looks into the psychology behind it all. You know, this tendency for the least equipped folks to often be the most confident.
It's fascinating. And the thing that really jumps out almost immediately is this finding. The less competent someone actually is in something, the more likely they are to think they're, well, exceptional at it. Okay, let's unpack this a bit.
It definitely sounds like that old Bertrand Russell idea, you know? The trouble with the world is that the stupid are cocksure and the intelligent are full of doubt.
Right, I've heard that one.
And while that was, you know, more of an observation back then, science has actually looked into it. Research has generally confirmed this link. Low competence often goes hand in hand with high confidence.
It's pretty interesting that they actually tested that intuition. And speaking of clues, wasn't there that survey, the one about intelligence?
Oh, yeah. That finding where something like, what was it, 94% of people rated themselves as more intelligent than average.
94%.
Yeah.
I mean, mathematically, that just doesn't work, does it?
Not really. So that alone tells you there's this widespread tendency to, well, overestimate ourselves.
Okay, so that sets the stage. And this kind of overestimation is where David Dunning and Justin Kruger come in. From Cornell.
Exactly. Their work is really central here. They looked right into this phenomenon, and it actually earned them an Ig Nobel Prize back in 2000.
An Ig Nobel. I love those. For research that makes you laugh, then think, right?
That's the one. And their work definitely fits, makes you think about something kind of weird, but also really relevant.
And the story that apparently got them started on it is just unbelievable. The world's dumbest bank robber. You have to tell that one.
Oh, it's a classic. So the story goes, this guy robbed banks, believing that putting lemon juice on his face made him invisible to security cameras.
Lemon juice? Seriously? Because of invisible ink?
Apparently that was the logic. A completely flawed understanding, obviously. But it's such a stark example, isn't it? Someone so unaware of their own, well, profound incompetence.
Wow. Yeah, that's... that really illustrates the point.
And it apparently directly sparked Dunning and Kruger's curiosity. They thought, okay, how can someone be that wrong about their own abilities?
How did they actually study this? What did the experiments look like? Did they use lemon juice?
Huh. No lemon juice in the lab. They set up some clever experiments with university students.
Okay.
They gave them tests, things like logic, grammar, even humor, I think. And then, crucially, they asked the students to estimate how well they thought they did. How they ranked compared to others.
Ah, the self-assessment piece. And what did they find there? This is where it gets really interesting, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Across all these different tests, the pattern was consistent. The students who scored the lowest on the actual tests, they significantly overestimated their performance.
So the bottom performers thought they were near the top.
Or at least well above average, yeah. They genuinely believed they were much more competent than they actually were.
And what about the top performers?
Well, they were much more accurate. If anything, sometimes they slightly underestimated how well they did compared to others.
Okay, so the people who knew the least were the most overconfident, and the people who knew the most were more realistic, maybe even a bit humble.
Pretty much. That was a key finding. But then they did a follow-up that was even more revealing.
What was that?
They actually showed the students their real scores. Compared their performance to others.
Okay, so confronting them with the evidence, did that change their minds, especially the low performers?
You'd think so, wouldn't you? But here's the kicker. The lowest performing students, even when shown their poor scores, they mostly didn't change their self-assessment much.
They didn't? What did they say?
They tended to stick to their guns, argued they were knowledgeable, and maybe the test was flawed or it was just bad luck that day, you know?
Wow. So they just dismiss the evidence, double down on feeling competent.
Exactly. It really shows this disconnect, doesn't it, between their perception and the reality?
Yeah, definitely. So from all this, Dunning and Kruger pulled together their main conclusions, right?
Right.
There were like four key points.
That's right. Four main takeaways that seem to apply pretty broadly: academics, driving, social skills, you name it. First, the really incompetent folks. They just can't recognize their own lack of skill.
They don't know what they don't know.
Precisely. And it's not just not knowing facts, it's lacking the awareness that they're lacking something.
Wait.
Second, because of that, they also can't recognize genuine skill in other people easily.
Okay. So their own lack of skill sort of blinds them to expertise elsewhere.
Seems like it. Third, they can't accurately judge just how incompetent they are. Their estimation is way off, much more than competent people's estimations.
Okay, points 1, 2, 3 paint a pretty clear picture. A bit bleak, maybe.
Yeah.
But there was a fourth point, wasn't there? Something a bit more hopeful.
Yes, exactly. The fourth point offers a way out, sort of. It's that as people do gain competence in an area, as they actually learn and improve,
uh-huh.
they also gain the ability to recognize their previous lack of skill. They start to see how much they didn't know before.
Ah, okay. So getting better at something also makes you better at judging competence, including your own past incompetence.
That's the idea. Like learning an instrument at first, you might think you sound okay, but the more you practice and learn, the more you realize, wow, I was really rough back then.
Right, right. Makes sense. But if you never get better,
then you might stay stuck in that initial phase of overconfidence. And those first three points can create a kind of cycle, you see.
How so?
Well, the incompetence leads to feeling good about yourself, maybe overly confident,
what?
Which might make you dismiss criticism or feedback.
Because you think you already know it all.
Right. And that dismissal prevents you from actually improving, which is the only way, according to point 4, to realize you weren't that good to begin with.
So it's a self-reinforcing bubble of perceived competence.
Wow. And this whole package, this whole pattern, now has a name, thanks to them.
Who it is?
The Dunning-Kruger effect. Named after the researchers, obviously.
The Dunning-Kruger effect. Okay. It really puts a label on something many of us have probably observed.
Definitely. And the source material we looked at had a, let's say, a rather blunt final thought on it.
Oh, yeah. What was that?
It basically said, look, if you run into someone who fits this description frustratingly wrong but totally sure of themselves, you can, you know, mentally file it under the Dunning-Kruger effect.
Okay.
But it added, don't expect them to understand the concept if you try to explain it.
Oh. Which kind of perfectly proves the point, doesn't it?
No.
If they can't recognize their incompetence, they probably can't recognize a description of it either.
Pretty much sums it up. It's a bit ironic, yeah.
So for you listening, the big takeaway here is really about this, well, this gap, this sometimes huge disconnect between how good someone thinks they are at something and how good they actually are.
Exactly. And that naturally leads to a question for you, doesn't it? Knowing about this effect, how do you think about your own skills, your own knowledge?
Yeah, that's the tricky part. How do you evaluate yourself accurately? How do you stay open to finding your own blind spots, you know?
It's a challenge. Maybe it involves seeking out honest feedback. Comparing your understanding against reliable sources, being willing to admit, I don't know.
Definitely something to reflect on. Have you maybe seen this effect in action?
Mm-hmm.
Perhaps even, dare I say it, in yourself sometimes. We all have areas where we know less.
Right. And the idea isn't to judge, but maybe just to understand the psychology behind it a bit better.
It encourages a bit of humility, maybe,
yeah.
And a commitment to keep learning.
I think so. Understanding the Dunning-Kruger effect is really a reminder that genuine expertise often comes with an awareness of how much more there is to learn. Food for thought, definitely.